Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ. Good morning and welcome to you all to this live broadcast of Pope Francis's Angelus Address this Sunday the 13th of October. On behalf of all of my colleagues here at the Vatican's Dicastery for Communication, a very warm welcome. Whether you are joining us through our Vatican Media app, or via our YouTube channel or Facebook, and whether you are joining us via any local or diocesan radio station, including EWTN Television English, Catholic Faith Network in America, Salt and Light Television, Radio Maria England, Shalom World Television, Atmadarshan Television, Catholic Television, Luminous Radio India, or via Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, a warm welcome to all of you. My name is Francesca Merlo, and it will be my pleasure to provide you with the English language translation of today's events. So in just a couple of minutes at 12 p.m. Rome time, on the dot, Pope Francis will be appearing at the window of the Apostolic Palace to meet the pilgrims in St. Peter's Square, and some of you will be able to see on the television, on the screen, images that you are watching, that there are lots of people in St. Peter's Square today. It's a beautiful day in Rome. The heat has finally calmed down, and so I think being in the square is perhaps more bearable. So Pope Francis will give a catechesis, for which I will be providing a simultaneous English translation. And after his catechesis, there will be the recitation of the Marian prayer, which he will recite along with all of the faithful in St. Peter's Square. After that, he usually greets some of the groups present, and he makes some appeals. Usually these appeals center on the theme of peace and on many of the humanitarian crises and injustices that plague the world in this period. But we will see later on. Should be just less than a minute until the Holy Father appears at the window, and usually you can hear that he's arrived before you can actually see, because all of the pilgrims in the square are watching that tiny window very, very attentively, and as soon as the curtains start to move, you can hear the crowd. And there it is, and there he is.
Cari fratelli e sorelle.
Buona domenica. Dear brothers and sisters, happy Sunday. The Gospel of today's liturgy tells us about a rich man who encounters Jesus and asks him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus invites him to leave everything and follow him. But the man, sorrowful, goes away because, as the text says, he had great possessions. It's difficult to leave everything. We can see the two movements of this man. At first, he runs to go to Jesus. At the end, though, he goes away sorrowful. He goes away sad. First, he runs towards, and then he goes away. Let us dwell on this. First and foremost, this man goes to Jesus running. It is as if something in his heart urges him on. In fact, although he has many riches, he is dissatisfied. He feels restlessness inside, and he is searching for a fuller life. As the sick and the possessed often do, he throws himself at the Master's feet. He is rich, yet in need of healing. Rich, yet in need of healing. Jesus looks at him with love. Then he proposes a therapy: to sell everything he has, give it to the poor, and follow him. But at this point comes an unexpected conclusion. The man's face falls, and he goes away.
Tanto grande e impetuoso è stato il desiderio di incontrare Gesù quanto freddo e veloce.
So great and impetuous was his desire to meet Jesus. How cold and swift was his farewell. We too carry in our hearts an irrepressible need for happiness and for a life full of meaning. However, we can fall into the illusion of thinking that the answer is found in the possession of material things and earthly securities. Instead, Jesus wants to bring us back to the truth of our desires and to make us discover that in reality, the goodness we yearn for is God Himself, His love for us, and the eternal life that He, and He only, can give us. The true wealth is to be looked upon with love by Him. It's a great richness, as Jesus does with that man, and to love each other by making our life a gift for others. Brothers and sisters, therefore Jesus invites us to risk love, to sell everything, to give it to the poor. What does this mean? It means divesting ourselves and of our false securities, making ourselves attentive to those who are in need, and sharing our possessions, not just things, but what we are, our talents, our friendship, our time, and so on.
Fratelli e sorelle, quell'uomo ricco.
Brothers and sisters, that rich man did not want to risk. Risk what? He did not want to risk love. And he went away with a sad face. And us, let us ask ourselves, what is our heart attached to? How do we satiate our hunger for life and happiness? Do we know how to share with those who are poor, with those who are in difficulty or in need of a little listening, of a smile, of a word to help them to regain hope? Somebody who needs to be listened to. Let us remember this. True wealth is not the goods of this world. True wealth is being loved by God and learning to love like Him. And now let us ask for the intercession of the Virgin Mary so that she may help us discover in Jesus the treasure of life.
Ave
Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre, amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre, amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Caritate nobis.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Tu digne officiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quesum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, che angel annunciante Christi Fili tu incarnazione coniovim, per passione meius ad crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Santo.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam donaeis Domine.
Et lux perpetua nocet Deis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domine.
Qui fecit caelum et terra.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Cari fratelli e sorelle,
dear brothers and sisters, I continue to follow with worry all that is happening in the Middle East. And I ask once again an immediate ceasefire on all fronts. May we undergo the routes of diplomacy and dialogue to obtain peace. I am close to all the populations involved, Palestine, Israel, Lebanon, where I ask that the forces of peace of the United Nations, the UN Peace Corps, be respected. I pray for all the victims. I pray for the hostages. I hope that they are released soon. And I pray that all this terrible suffering fueled by hatred and revenge ends soon. Brothers and sisters, war is an illusion. It is a defeat. It will never bring peace. It will never bring security. It is a defeat for everybody, especially for those who believe they are invincible. Stop, please. I turn my appeal so that Ukrainians may not be left to die of cold. May airstrikes against the civil population stop. The civilians are always those who are most hard hit. Stop killing innocent people. I am following the dramatic situation in Haiti, where violence against the population continues. The population who is forced to flee from their own homes in search of security elsewhere, within and outside the country. Let us never forget our brothers and sisters. I pray that all violence stops, and that with the help of the international population, all rights may be restored for everyone. Hello to you Romans, pilgrims from Rome, from Italy, and from many other countries. Pope Francis is now greeting various groups that are participating in this Angelus. A group of Paralympic sports people, a group from Pax Christi International, and some students whom he says he met in the morning.
La Fondazione Aiuto alla Chiesa che soffre promuove l'iniziativa Un milione di bambini.
The Pontifical Foundation Aid to the Church in Need is promoting an initiative 1 million children praying the Rosary for peace in the world. Thank you to all the young boys and girls who are taking part. We entrust ourselves to them and to the intercession of the Virgin Mary on the anniversary of the last apparition at Fatima. And to her we entrust tormented Ukraine, Myanmar, Sudan, and all populations who suffer war and any form of violence and misery. Hello to the young people of the Immacolata. I see Polish, Brazilian, Argentinian flags, Ecuador, France. Hello to all of you. And have a wonderful Sunday. And of course, please do not forget to pray for me. Enjoy your lunch and arrivederci. See you soon. And Pope Francis is waving goodbye to all of the pilgrims in St. Peter's Square. And on that note, I too will say goodbye, because that does bring an end to this live broadcast of Pope Francis's Angelus address this Sunday, the 13th of October. So whether you have joined us through our Vatican Media app or via our YouTube channel or Facebook page, thank you for being with us, and thank you to all of you who joined via any local or diocesan radio station. And these include EWTN Television English, Catholic Faith Network in America, Salt and Light Television, Radio Maria England, Shalom World Television, Atmadarshan Television, Catholic Television, Luminous Radio India, and Radio Maria Papua New Guinea. Thank you to all of you. My name is Francesca Merlo, and it has been my pleasure being with you today. So until next time, Laudetur Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ.